If you think Thanksgiving is the best meal of the year, you're doing it wrong. There's a meal that our family has been having for years, and it is on International Flauta Day. It's become bigger and more exciting than Thanksgiving. What's not to love about another holiday of all-you-can-eat food and good times? International Flauta Day is a family holiday that has fully customizable dishes and just about anyone can enjoy. I come from a lineage of flauta eaters. I've made many flautas in my day and many other dishes are some of my favorites that I make regularly. Today I will cover the family holiday tradition that is International Flauta Day, as well as the food involved. Here's a short video from 2022 by Hi I'm Monel on TikTok. All right, to start, I will share how Flauta Day became a family holiday tradition. It actually started as a way to stretch out leftover Thanksgiving turkey. It's usually celebrated the day after Thanksgiving, but can also be celebrated on a different day too, since it's flexible. The celebration lasts all day long though. Flauta Day is also about spending time with friends and family. We share in the crafting of food, we share in the eating of food, and we get to spend quality time with each other. It's really quite wholesome. The origins of Flauta Day started back with my nana. My nana used to casually make turkey flautas after Thanksgiving when my dad was little. Turkey flautas became a bigger deal when he was in his teens, happening every year. They were a perfect way to use leftover turkey. That wasn't just more sandwiches. It gave my nana a way to stretch her food budget and feed a lot of people all at once. You only need a minimal amount of shredded turkey per flauta, and this enabled her to expand the amount of food served to everyone who was already visiting for Thanksgiving. With the rest of the food being rice, beans, and veggies, all fairly inexpensive, my nana was able to feed 20, 30, 40 people easily. My dad continued the tradition after he left home. He recalls that he made flautas in the military at least once. While he dated my mom, he made it for her too. And once they got married though, they've made Flauta Day happen every year since. Even with his 6-year venture into a choir meetup nowadays, they continue the tradition on with all their new lifelong friends. As time goes on, family and friends are continuing the legacy that is Flauta Day. Of course, I am here telling you about the wonderful day because I love it so much. Both of my brothers and their significant others go all out each year with their delicious celebrations. Old family friends still reminisce each year about Flauta Day, sending messages of good wishes or jealousy. And ever since my dad's meetup choir started celebrating each year, they have always expressed their excitement and anticipation. Next, I would like to talk about the types of food for Flauta Day. Of course, there's the flautas I keep talking about. Flautas sound simple to me, with corn tortillas wrapped around shredded turkey, then fried in oil. But to explain the nuance, my brother, Joel H. Hinojosa, wrote to me regarding the crafting of flautas. Most of the kitchens I've cooked in for Flauta Day have been pretty small. So I've had to find a rhythm that works with the space. The tortillas are flexible for a limited amount of time, which means you have to be constructing them as you go, which I've usually done by dabbing the tortilla with a little water, putting them in the oven to warm up a little. Then the flexible tortilla can be wrapped around whatever the filling is and held together with a toothpick. You want to pay attention to the fry and that you are turning the flauta over at a good point, but you also want to have one or two prepped and waiting in the wings. The fry oil needs to be adjusted as it loses or gains heat. And when the flauta is finished, you want to move it to the oven to stay warm. These are all the tasks you're negotiating time for, and each task has certain requirements. Every time I've cooked the flautas on flauta day, there will come a point where I find a good balance and the majority of the flautas come out consistently fried and very few tortillas break during the construction. However, since Joel is a seasoned pro at this point, Amy Holston, his significant other, had this to say in her writings to me. It's important to designate who is responsible for each element's preparation. There's the prepping and frying of the flautas, of course. This can be a 1 to 2 person job. Now, with my family and some friends, we have those who are now vegetarian or vegan and have created new ways to enjoy the same flavors of flauta day. We found a popular plant-based substitute for turkey to work wonderfully. As for the rest of the other ingredients required of the day, they're unintentionally vegan. As flautas aren't the only thing you eat that day, I will share some of our other dishes with you. Quickie salsa, much like its name, is salsa made quick. It's made under 45 seconds in a blender. And if your salsa turns frothy and more orange, you've blended it too long. If you can also add cilantro if you don't have any people who taste soap instead. There's also salsa fresca, which is your typical chunky salsa, or some interchange it with the name pico de gallo. We also have my personal favorite, the star of the show, guacamole. Smash your avocados, the more the merrier. Add some salsa fresca to it, along with squirts of lime, and you have your guacamole. You can add some tortilla chips to go with it. But once again, I've got to quote Amy Holston, who wrote to me, "If nothing else, a flauta is truly a perfectly fried guacamole vessel." We can't forget the Spanish rice and beans either. The trick with the rice is to cook it dry in some oil in a pan until it's browned. Then add the tomato sauce, water, and spices to simmer. As for the beans, similarly, you start it early in the day in a pot of water to simmer in spices for several hours, refilling the water as it absorbs. With all this said, there's many ways to customize the flauta day meal. As it's evolved and spread throughout our families and friends, some dishes have been changed or added. Recipes have been changed around for various reasons, but we don't judge. It ends up being a very versatile meal for just about anyone. In summary, I've covered the holiday my family established called International Flauta Day, as well as having gone over the dishes we eat. International Flauta Day is a family holiday with customizable dishes that so many people can enjoy. In the end, I hope I showed you even just a piece of the joy that this day brings me and others through our traditions of food that all started with a very crafty lady, my Nana. Thank you, Nana. May she continue to rest in peace.